हेलो स्टूडेंट्स,
वेलकम टू उमा देवी चिल्ड्रन एकेडमी।
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल। लेक्चर नंबर 9, इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल? द इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल मीन्स इट इज़ ए प्रोसेस ऑफ कन्वर्जन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इंटू केमिकल एनर्जी। स्टूडेंट्स, so what is that means? It means if you are use the A chemicals, A is the chemical, with the help of A chemical, with the help of electrical energy, A chemical turns into B. This is we called as a one chemical species turns into another chemical form with the help of electrical energy. That process we called as electrolytic cell. Understood, students? So let's see one example. Molten NaCl solution dipped into platinum electrode connected with battery. Battery positive terminal called as anode, negative terminal called as cathode. NaCl dissociate to form Na plus and Cl minus. Na plus and Cl minus. So Na plus and Cl minus are move randomly in the solution. There is no attraction and repulsion between them. So they are more randomly in the solutions. There is no attraction between the sodium to chloride. There is no repulsion between the sodium and chloride. They are more randomly. So Cl minus ion move towards anode and it oxidizes. So anode formula, these are anode, students. Just make correction here. Anode, the Cl minus releasing electron, these are minus, students, please make correction. Cl minus turns into so in this case the anode Cl minus releasing electron to form half Cl2, this make here correction, half Cl2, and it is the oxidation reactions. Sodium plus move towards cathode, it undergoes reduction reaction take place. The cathode, sodium plus accepting electron to form sodium atom. That is the reduction reactions. Right. So it means, friends, the beaker in which we are using the NaCl solution, dip the platinum electrodes, the sodium ions attract toward the cathode and the Cl minus ion attract toward the anodes, right? And the sodium, which is sodium, undergoes reduction reaction occurs, and the chloride undergoes oxidation reactions. Okay, students, at the anode, the Cl minus turns into half Cl2 by releasing one electrons. That is the oxidation reaction take place. Cathode, Na plus accept electron to form sodium atom, that is reduction reactions are take place here. Total reaction, or you may say net reaction. The first we always write the oxidation reaction, that is anode side always oxidation reaction, and the cathodes are always reduction reactions. So Cl minus Na plus turns into half Cl2 and Na plus. Cl minus converted into Cl atom, Na plus converted into Na atom. It is not an atom, students. It is an atom, right? So whatever the above reaction is there, these above reactions are represented by the standard way of representation. That is the formula is anode product. These two lines are indicated the salt. There is the electrodes and the cathode product and cathode. Anode product and the electrodes, cathode product and cathodes. Right, students? So what is anode product, students? The anode product is, anode is the platinum. We are using platinum, so anode is the platinum. And the anode product is half Cl2 anode product. Cathode product is Na, and the cathode is the platinum. Right, friends? So the whatever the reactions are there, the reactions are represented by the in this form. Right, friends? So here the diagram is there here. The beaker in which contain Na plus Cl minus. So battery. So battery is there. In this battery, so battery is there here, students. This is the battery. Battery positive terminal. It means the whatever the electrons, the this platinum electrode is there. This is the platinum, and this is also platinum. So electrode, negative charge electrode, which are absorb the electron from the positive terminal, which is absorbed. What are the platinum electrodes are there? The platinum electrode from which the electrons are transferred to the this positive end, this positive end to again the negative terminal pushed all the electrons over this one. Understood? Once again I will tell you, the battery negative terminals which is absorb the all the electrons, whatever the electrons are there here, this all the electrons are withdraw it. And what are the withdraw electrons are there, the our withdraw electrons are pushed over this electrode. So that's why the from this positive terminal electrons are transferred to the negative terminals. So that's why develop positive charge and this is develop negative charge. Right, friends? So in that condition, the sodium ions move towards positive electrode anode and lose one electrons. Sodium ion accept one electrons from cathode and reduce here. So this is the oxidation reaction and this is reduction reaction in the maltol NaCl. Right, students? This is the first example, students. I hope you understood. So next is the one of the interesting example, that is the electrolysis of the aqueous NaCl. Aqueous NaCl electrolysis. So aqueous NaCl in presence of platinum electrode, the solution in which sodium ion, chloride ions, both ions move randomly in the solution. So whatever sodium chloride crystal is there, the sodium chloride crystals in which we are adding water. If you are adding water, means the sodium chloride crystal get dissociated. After dissociation, it turns into sodium ion and the chloride ion. Right, friends? Next, and during the electrolysis in mean here the water is there, water also electrolyzed with the help of battery, water electrolyzed to form H plus OH minus, H plus and OH minus. The solution contain two positive ions, that is Na plus H minus, and two negative ions Cl minus and OH minus. Right, friends? The initially we are use the NaCl salt in which we may add water, NaCl get dissociated to form Na plus and Cl minus. Here, this reaction. Next, during the electrolysis, water also electrolyzes. When we switch on the battery, water also electrolyzed, it get dissociated to form H plus and OH minus. It means the solution contain two positive ions, sodium ion, hydrogen ion, two positive ions, and solution contain two negative ions, chloride ion, hydroxyl ions. Right, friends? So in this case, the beaker which contain the Na plus Cl minus, H plus OH minus. Right, friends? So tell me, so in this reaction, can the chloride and hydroxide, can both chloride and hydroxide oxidize at the anode? No, can both positive charge sodium ion and hydrogen ion reduce at the cathode? No. So question I mentioned here, can both negative charge ion chloride hydroxide oxidize at the anode? Answer is no students. The only that ion oxidizes which have a high oxidation potential, right? Which have a high oxidation potential. When you compare the chloride ion and the hydroxide ion, the only that ions which lose the electron, both are different ions. It means both have a different oxidation potential. Both ions, Cl minus and OH minus ion, both have a different electron releasing tendency. Right. Some species release more faster release electron. Some species slowly release electrons or cannot release electrons. Right. So that is according to electrochemical series, chloride ion has high oxidation potential than hydroxyl ion. Therefore, chloride ion oxidizes and hydroxyl ions remains in the solutions. Students, chloride ions are oxidizes and the hydroxide ion remains in the solutions. So it means when we use the battery in which where the competition between the OH and Cl minus at the anode, Cl minus move towards cathode, OH remains in the solutions. Students, okay, look at here. I will show you. This is the oxidation potential. So this is the oxidizing agent. Here the oxidation potential mentioned here. This is the oxidizing agent element, and this is the oxidation potential. When you compare the hydroxyl ion here and the chloride ion here, so hydroxyl ion oxidation potential is 2.87 volt and chloride ion oxidation potential is 1.36. It means chlorine value is very small. Chloride value very small. If chloride value very small means chloride is more easily release electron than the hydroxyl ions. Chloride have a high oxidation potential, more easily release electron than the hydroxide. So that's why chloride ions are moved towards anode and the OH remains in the solutions. Right, students? Okay. Next question. Question is, can both positive charge ion, sodium and hydrogen ion, reduces at cathode? Answer is no. Only those ion reducers which have a high reduction potential. Only that ions are reducers which have a high reduction potential. In above condition, hydrogen ion have a high reduction potential than sodium ion. Therefore, hydrogen ion reduces at cathode and sodium ion remains in the solution. The hydrogen ions reduction potential. Hydrogen ions are more easily accept electron. When you head the competition, hydrogen ion and the sodium ion. The hydrogen ion accept electron in 1 second, simply general example, and the sodium ions are accepting electron in a 20 second. To tell me students, which one is more easily moved towards cathode? Correct answer is hydrogen ion, because hydrogen ion reduction potential is so fast, it accept electron in 1 second, as compared to sodium. Sodium accepts electron in 20 seconds. So hydrogen ion reduction potential is, hydrogen ion reduction potential is greater than the sodium ion, so that's why it moved towards cathode. Yes, students. Okay, look at here, students. The oxidizing and reducing agent and of the hydrogen and sodium I am giving shown here. The sodium is here. The sodium accepts electron in -2.71, and the hydrogen accepts electron in 0 electron volt. So it means the hydrogen is more easily accept electron as compared to the sodium. So sodium remains in the solution and hydrogen move towards cathode. Right, students? So this is the beaker, the Na plus, Cl minus, and the H and OH are there here. So chlorine move towards it. Chlorine ion move towards anode, hydrogen ions are move towards at cathode, and the remaining the solution forms here NaOH. Right, students? So it means, what is that means, students? We are using the NaCl plus water. After electrolysis, it turns into NaOH plus NaOH plus H2 plus Cl2. We are using NaCl plus water. After electrolysis, it turns into NaOH and hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. Right, students? So here the reaction here. At anode, chlorine is reduces, accept electron to form chlorine gas. Cathode, hydrogen ion accept electron to form hydrogen gas at the cathode. Total reaction, chloride ion, hydrogen ion turns into chlorine gas, hydrogen gas. Okay, next, understood, students? So next step. Next is, chloride ion partner is sodium ion, hydrogen ion partner is OH minus ion. Again, Cl partner is Na, H2 plus partner is OH. Right? Again, you combine these reactions. Then what you got? This reaction, students, you have combined this two reaction. Then Na plus Cl minus combined to form Na plus, H plus OH minus combined to form H2O, and the half Cl2 as it is the move towards the Cl2 move towards at anode, H2 which is move towards at cathode. And the solution forms NaOH. NaOH solution is formed here. Right, students? So it means it is a process of conversion of electrical energy. With the help of electrical energy, aqueous NaCl turns into NaOH. Right, students? Understood? I hope you understood, students. So I hope you understood. If you have any doubt, then ask me, students. Thank you.